lung volumes and lung capacities. So usually, nahihirapan tayo mag-memorize nun. So I will just try to share how I study it and how I try to recall it. Usually kasi maraming nalilito dito, maraming naguguluhan. Pero I will try an easy way on how you are going to memorize it. Kasi baka itanong siya. Kasi since nursing ako, tinatanong na din siya noon. So ngayon sa medicine, tatanungin din. Baka tanungin din. So at least alam na po natin. Okay? Let's go! So I'll just get my review notebook. So usually dito ko nilalagay yung mga diagrams, mga flowcharts na mga inaaral. Kasi important kasi sinisimplify mo yung mga bagay-bagay kasi bakit ba natin gagawin komplikado? So itong mga sinusulat ko dito, mga high yield lang. Again, lung volumes and capacities. Okay, so mag-start tayo mag-drawing ng box. And then, hatiin natin siya. Tatandaan natin na merong apat na volumes, 4 volumes, at meron ding apat na capacity. Medyo nakakagulo lang siya, pero tig-apat lang yan. And then, ang una mong aalalahanin is yung tidal volume. So, numberan mo na siya. Numberan mo na siya based doon sa paano mo siya i-memorize. So, your tidal volume is this. So, your tidal volume is the volume of air inspired and expired during normal or quiet breathing. So, usually 500 yun. Inspired and expired. Ang tatandaan mo dyan, normal breathing. Normal breathing. So, ang wave niyan usually is ganito. Okay. So, ngayon, ang next mong alalahanin ay yung inspiratory reserve volume. So, that's gonna be your number 2. Yung mahaba. So, gawin lang natin IRV or your inspiratory reserve volume. So, yung inspiratory reserve volume, that's beyond the volume of air inspired after your normal breath. So, usually, yan yung during exercises. So, dahil reserve siya, extra siya. So, extra amount of air. So, yun yung other words nun. So, again, inspire after tidal volume. Tidal volume. So, pwedeng during exercise. So, R siya. So, extra. So, kapag ganyan, diba, ito yung normal na. Inhale, exhale, and then hihinga ka ng, yan. So, mas mataas siya. Back mo dito. Ngayon, for your third volume, that's gonna be your expiratory naman. Partner sila, expiratory reserve volume. So, kung may inspiratory, meron ding expiratory. So, i-box natin to para i-highlight natin siya. So, kung meron kang inspire, this one is your expire. This is the volume of air expired after the normal breathing. Kasi yung tidal volume mo, that is composed of inspired and expired. Expired after tidal volume. Yan. So, kapag naalala mo yan, you're almost complete. So, ito, since ito yung tidal volume natin, mag-exceed lang siya. So, makikita mo siya dito. Yan. So, sorry, medyo pangit. Yan yun. And then, now, this one is your number 4. So, yung number 4 mo, this is immeasurable by spirometry. Your residual volume is the volume that remains in the lungs after the maximal expiration. So, again, immeasurable siya by spirometry. Max expiration. Yun, magandang i-take note dito. Yan. So, ito. Ito lang. Bali, ang tatandaan mo lang is yung number 1. And then, meron mag-partner. Si 2 at saka si 3. Siya si IRV at si ERV. Kasi, syempre, kung may mag-i-inspire, may mag-i-expire. And then, ito na. Tapos na tayo sa volumes natin. Now, we are going to your capacities. So, sa capacities, again, we also have 4. So, ang unahin natin ngayon is the easiest to remember. So, that is your total lung capacity, which is the maximal volume that can be contained in a lung. So, that's everything. So, tanda mo lang dyan ang all. So, kung all, pwede mo nang ilagay dyan yung tire. Tire. Yun, tidal volume, inspiratory, residual, and your expiratory. Yan. And then, the next one there, na aalalahanin mo, is your vital capacity, or the forced vital capacity, which is the sum of your tidal volume, your IRV, and the ERV. Yeah. So, lagyan na lang natin ng magandang line dito. Kuha tayo ng magandang color. Maganda to. This is what, again, this is your vital capacity. Vital capacity. Para hindi ka malito, dahil yan, pwede mong isipin na tie. That's your tidal volume, IRV and ERV. Or, pwede rin naman na 1, 2, and 3. Para mas madali. 1, 2, and 3 lang eh. Ayan, diba? And then, so, meron ka ng pangalawa. Ito yung una mo. Ito yung pangalawa mo. So, yung pangatlo mong aalalahanin is your inspiratory capacity, which is the sum of your tidal volume and the IRV. So, kuha tayo ng another color. Ayan. Tidal volume and the IRV. Pink. Ayan. Is the one we call as your inspiratory capacity. Inspiratory capacity. One and two or TI. TI lang. TI, hindi TI. And then, di ba yan na yung third mo? The last one is your functional residual capacity, which is the sum of ERV and RV. And that is the volume remaining in the lungs after a tidal volume is expired. So, kapag ganon, since it includes your RV again, yan na siya, it means it's also not measurable by spirometry. It is immeasurable. So, ilalabel na lang natin siya as your number 4. That's your functional residual capacity. Kung meron kang 1 plus 2, ito naman ay 3 plus 4. 3 plus 4, ERV plus RV. O RE. RE na lang. Kasi diba ang tatandaan natin yung tire. So there you go, we already have discussed the lung volumes and the capacities. So, ano ba yung usual implications nito, no? So, again, I just also want to emphasize that total lung capacity is also immeasurable because it contains the R or the residual volume, which is immeasurable by spirometry. Okay? So, for the clinical correlations, what we have here is the forced expiratory volume or yung FEV1. So FEV1 is the volume of air that can be expired. Kasi expiratory volume yan eh. Expired in the first second. In the first second. So para kang bubuga nun, first second. Of a forced maximal expiration. So, yun yung mga clause natin. Of a forced maximal expiration. So, normally, this is 80%. 80% of the forced vital capacity. So, equation yan is this one. FEVE 1 over FVC is equal to 0.8. So, ito yung usually na tinitignan kapag you're considering obstructive lung diseases and restrictive lung diseases. So, yung obstructive lung diseases like your COPD, emphysema bronchitis, so yan yun. So, kapag reduce siya, reduced FEV1 over FVC ratio, pwedeng obstructive. And then, kapag ka-increase naman siya, pwede siyang restrictive. So your restrictive diseases includes those pulmonary fibrosis. So, ayan. So, ayan guys. So, I hope na-gets niyo po yung inaral natin today. And sana po, nakatulong po ako sa inyo. At sana po napadali yung pag-aaral. That's all for now. Thank you.